The award-winning writer Tahar Ben-Jelloun guided his protégé Edem Awoumi as he began his third novel. Edem, who is from Togo but based in Quebec, benefited from his mentor's advice on character and story development in meetings in Paris and Morocco.
Literature needs flaws, injuries, blood, fights, violence. That's what literature is. It's not reassuring, it's disturbing. When I read a novel before going to sleep, I sometimes sleep badly because I'm troubled. I'm very observant. I live in town. I see people. I go to cafes. I listen to what's being said. I read the newspapers. A writer is not someone who lives in a bubble. He's someone who's part of life. And life is full of things, full of events. I can't be content just with my own imagination.
Dark nights and ghosts are the backdrop, the world where I feel I am myself. I am a line, a dark streak, a detail on a painting, a life, a song that could be written without a trace of light on the stone of an alleyway. You are confronted by your own dreams, ghosts and desires. It's a solitary activity, but it's also one of sharing and communication. You are on your own, but you're not totally alone. When I began sending my first drafts to Tahar, he was very tough. He said, "What are you doing? No, that's not the way to write. It's not credible. You have to construct something convincing. People have to believe in the destiny of your character." He gave me books to read, Sabato, Joyce. He asked me to reread The Sound of the Fury by William Faulkner.
We communicate by email. He sends me a chapter, I read it, I tell him what I think. But I prefer the other method we've been using here. That is, we talk. I'm not interested in being an editor or a teacher. I want to be someone who accompanies a writer as he writes. I work as a colleague, as someone with whom I exchange ideas about writing, about narration, and about characters.
I think this program is fantastic. It has given me the opportunity of going beyond my world. And in a very technical, precise way, being able to devote myself to writing for a year is a great opportunity.
I thought that Edem represented the closest match to the spirit of the Rolex program. He has a true passion for literature. He's possessed by that passion to such an extent that I am sometimes obliged to hold him back a bit and channel him because he overflows.